What is up, everyone, and welcome back to Philippines. So I am on an island called Apo Island. This is like a 30 to 45 minute boat ride from Dumaguete area. So I think it's called Malatape. I'm with my friends, my Canadian friends again that I met a couple days ago. So we've been traveling around together for a little bit. So it's been a lot of fun. But we got our own sort of private boat tour today. Costs a little bit of money. It was like 3,500 pesos. But in the long run, it's just so much easier because it is quite a hard island to get to. They only have like one ferry a day coming here and then another ferry a day going back. Then you got to pay like an island. Then you got to pay a fee on the island as well, just because this whole island is really protected. So it's very famous for snorkeling and scuba diving. So that's what we're going to do today. And our boat is going to take us all around the island. And as you can see, we got a bit wet coming over here just because it's a bit rough. But yeah, we got a whole day on Apo Island. So let's go explore. Time to dig into our lunch, provided lunch for the tour. Look at all this stuff, we just keep getting food coming and coming. We got prawns, we got mussels, we got a big tower of rice. We got some delicious looking meat. This is a good buffet right here. Nice chicken you got there. Okay, so we have a fair bit of time to spare now. So we're just gonna explore the rest of the island. We're gonna make our way to the top of Apo Island, like just get a 360 viewpoint. And I think there's like a couple more beaches around here too. So we just grabbed our snorkel gear and yeah, we'll just venture from beach to beach and go snorkeling ourselves. Here, sorry if the audio is not too good. So I don't know what to say, guys, but Apo Island, I am a little bit disappointed. So after seeing the few beaches and after snorkeling from this morning, like it doesn't make sense. So for this island, it was very expensive to come to, and they say, from what I've heard, is like one of the most protective reefs around the Philippines. And you have to actually pay 100 pesos on an entrance fee for like the marine sanctuary to keep it clean and to keep it protected. But as you can see, like right now, there's rubbish everywhere along this whole entire beach. There is rubbish. That's why I'm very confused of how, where this money is going towards and how they're keeping it clean. And even in the coral reefs we were swimming around this morning, like some areas were pretty nice, but as you can see, like other areas were just completely destroyed. And the tour guides, like apparently you have to have a tour guide with you like while you're snorkeling for some weird reason. You don't really need to, I feel. And no one shows respect. Like these tour guides, I could obviously see him just stepping on all this coral, just crushing the coral. So it just makes me wonder why it is so expensive to get to this island, why you gotta pay a so-called fee to get to this island, and why it is just like rubbish everywhere and it's obviously not protected like they said it should be. So I'm not saying don't come to this island. All I'm saying is this is the truth behind this island. I thought it was gonna be a lot more. I thought it was gonna be a lot more better just because of the fact that I paid so much. It's the most, one of the most expensive places I paid to get to an island around the Philippines. And like I can easily say I had much more of a better experience in Mobile. Like when it was free to go snorkeling, the reefs around there were very beautiful. Of course, two other parts were a bit destroyed, but yes, just rubbish everywhere. So, I don't know, that's just my opinion. And yeah, do what you want, but if all I can say is Apo Island has really disappointed me in a way. And yeah, it's just, they need to do a better job maintaining it if this is called a sanctuary. No better way to have an island experience than cracking open a nice, fresh coconut. Yeah. You get a good one? Oh, there goes all the milk. Nice. Looks good. Oh, well, that was pretty chilled while it lasted. But now we got several of these long, steep steps to get to the bottom. So I'll meet you there. All right, we are back and we are extremely sweaty. It is just such a hot day today. It's such a little island, but trekking on throughout this whole island is quite exhausting just because it's so extremely warm. But we are now going to make our way all the way back to Dumanguete. It is going to be quite an adventurous ride just because it is extremely rough. But I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. And as I said before, like just look at this video as what I've showed you. If you feel like you still want to come here, then come here. But all I am saying is, from my experience, is I prefer other islands instead. I have also heard the diving is really good, so that might be like a whole different thing. Like, I don't know exactly where they dive, but yeah, the diving is probably well worth it around here. But from here on in, thanks for watching. Follow your dreams. Escape your comfort zone, and I will see you guys on another Philippine adventure. Bye.